Over 200 billion plastic bottles are created each year. Over 10% of them, that's 20 billion bottles, end up in our oceans. Some ride currents to massive islands of garbage called gyres. Others litter our beaches and waterways. The water is our backyard, our playground. Every day we see it suffocated by ocean trash. Costa started Kick Plastic campaign to do something about it, to tell people about the problem and put plastic in its place. We spread the word with videos, art, and events. We organized cleanups and rallied around the cause. We were excited to go out into the world and be part of the solution. But then we came home and looked around, and it was clear. We were part of the problem. We talked about how can we rid Costa of plastic. When we started walking through the facility and seeing plastic is everywhere, it's just like seeping through every nook and cranny of everything we do. It was a little bit shocking to see how much plastic we use. And so it's gonna take a lot more work than we had initially thought. T-shirts, for example, come in a plastic bag. We have banners that come wrapped in plastic. We have stickers that are made out of plastic. We have bubble wrap. We have tape on these boxes. But then we put those boxes on a pallet and we wrap them in even more plastic. We're gonna look at all that and see if there's a way that we, you know, can reduce that plastic or come up with biodegradable plastic or some other solution.
Our major plastic usage is the frame baggies. You figure last year we did 1 million glasses sold, so it's 1 million little baggies.
Things are gonna get a little bit more challenging when it comes to trying to phase out things like, you know, bags around the t-shirts or things that are not just something that we use, but also something that the people who we get our materials from use and the people who we're sending our materials to also use.
I worked with the vendors to find a source that is, it's an eco biodegradable bag for all the t-shirts.
We talked to receiving and we started recycling the bags.
We also are looking at trying to get a nylon canvas to wrap. You walk it around the pallet and you Velcro it tight.
I think it's pretty obvious that this is still going to be an ongoing process. As the company grows, our products change, you know, our vendors are gonna change, and so there's always gonna be places where we're gonna need to look to, you know, make improvements and sort of be plastic-minded.
I think it's been a great team-building effort for the employees here. It's become much more meaningful, and the success of it is much more part of who they are, too.
I feel like we have settled for sort of halfway solutions, and I don't feel like we've pushed hard enough. What about our products? Our sunglasses are made of plastic, and while they aren't the culprits that single-use products like bottles are, they still have an impact. Can we improve those as well? Our head of product design and I sat down with the team and took that on as a challenge. Let's make our actual sunglasses eco-friendly. Let's make sure we're doing what we're telling everyone else to do.
There's been a lot of innovation over the past decade in moving away from traditional plastics to bio-based plastics.
He began experimenting with wood, pulp, and cotton-based resins, and he brought a castor-based resin to the table that was strong and durable, but in very specific conditions, biodegrades in about 500 years faster than traditional plastic. Now our products are built to make the world a better place, and our production facilities are doing their part as well. The result's been incredible, but it's also been financially sound. There are some alternatives out there, and most of the time they're not even more expensive, as we actually saved money doing this. This issue has just got to be dealt with at a big level. It's just going to have to happen.
If we can get more and more people involved, you know, the power's in the numbers.
We have started accomplishing what we set out to do, so it's a really good start. If you're trying to motivate the bean counters, then there's an economic story to be told. If you're trying to influence the marketing people who want the company to have a positive image,
This is an issue that is on trend, that is growing, and that is very positively received by pretty much every customer group that you could think of. If you're trying to influence somebody who is environmentally sensitive and cares about that issue, there's a huge story to be told.
So far, we've made good headway, but there's still a lot to do. And the more companies that join in the movement, the bigger impact we will make.